I found a new boat. So today we have a brand new Beneteau First 27. Let's have a look around. So this is the First 27 in its standard configuration. There's also a Seascape edition, which is a fair bit racier, has an outboard motor, swing keel to make it a little bit easier to trailer, and also doesn't have these extended bench seats in the cockpit. I actually really like this model just for the versatility that it gives you with an inboard diesel. It just seems a little more reliable. Maybe you're a little more apt to take it offshore, a little bit further from home. These bench seats, of course, are great for day sailing, great for any type of sailing. If you're shorthanded racing, I think you would sit there quite a bit, given that this boat has a built-in autopilot. Nice storage within these bench seat compartments. We'll have a look there. Really nice interior fit out. This boat actually has the fridge compressor. There's a sort of an enclosed head and some other really nice features, that a table down below would really make overnighting and weekending a lot of fun to go along with the performance of this boat. This boat has the solar panel option, keep things charged up. You might keep this boat on a mooring or even while you're out on your cruise. Going forward, another little hatch, which is over the V-berth up in the bow. See an integrated anchor locker, just again showcasing the true cruising and you know, going places and using this boat capabilities. And then of course the retractable bowsprit. So looking aft, you can see definitely a lot of performance, a lot of race boat spirit in this boat, but a lot of comforts that would make this boat just a blast to go go weekending, go cruise around, depending on what your spirit of glamping is all about. So let's go down below and have a look at some of the other elements of the First 27. So I'm down below here on the First 27. This boat arrived to us at Cape Yahtzee yesterday. It arrives in a container, so we pull it out and really haven't had time to unpack the boat or do anything just yet. So just gonna give you a quick rundown of what I see here. The boat is really nicely packaged, and everything was secured down below and padded. Everything looks great. Let's have a little look around. So when you look around the First 27, some of the things you'll see might surprise you a little bit about a boat of this size. Really nice 12 volt panel, very legitimate electrical system versus what you might see on a smaller, I don't know, cheaper, I want to say, 27 footer meant for just day sailing. That's a little battery monitor right there. One thing that's cool about these boats are these removable bags of sorts. And if we look over here on this side, you'll see that they just come down and you get out the things that you put inside. You'll see that they zip open and you'll see that they come completely out. So you take them home, you pack them up, you bring them back, and you put them on board. You have all the things that you want to take with you, whether it's clothes or food or whatever it is. So really cool. This boat comes with a kit, which are six of them, four here in the main salon and two forward. You can see looking aft, it's a bit dark, I understand, but that's one berth area. Of course, there are cushions that go back there. Over on the starboard side, the same thing. That's your boom right there. Have these nice strong supports right here, which are the seat backs, but also provide for a lot more storage. Really nice lighting down below. Of course, you can see this is the companionway. These are the hatch boards in, and also the sliding hatch above. So look at all that light coming through. Also two windows over here in the cabin top, and then one window down here on the top sides. So looking forward, right in the middle here behind that compression post is where the removable table would be, and that's that same table that would fit into the cockpit. Looking up above the compression post, that's where your VHF is permanently installed. Nice feature for a boat of this size, not just relying on a handheld. And going forward, this is some of the coolest parts of the interior of this boat. You see what we do have. We're going to pass right through this middle section. We have our V-berth, which has another couple of those storage bags. This little section here in between the salon and the forward cabin is where we have a door to the head. Okay, and then this section really closes off. You see the space that it gives you. Not sure what this is on the floor here. It's just a bag. Then over on our port side, we have the galley. Look at that. Single burner, fully plumbed stove, meaning we have a gas tank out in the cockpit. None of this swinging device by the wall, race boat style. Then we also have a freshwater sink, so you can wash up after being in the head here. And then also, of course, part of your galley operations. Another little curtain here. Can't quite remove that just yet for more storage down below. And then if you are up in this area and you're at anchor, or even out sailing on a calm day, there's a nice hatch overhead, and then also a nice small hatch up forward over the V-berth. So a couple of things to look at in the cockpit here is the generous storage capability within these bench seats. In the center here, you see another mount for the table, which is dual purpose. The table down below comes up, plugs right in, gives you a nice place to sit out in the cockpit. And in the other cockpit locker here, which also has space for the propane tank for the built-in stove down below. Looking aft, it's a backstay control right there. And then also the manual emergency bilge pump over on the starboard side. See your engine controls for the Yanmar. We'll look down below in a moment, but you have a nice folding propeller. Goes along with the performance aspect. There is your Shore Power plug-in. And we're going to have a look down below here at some of the what goes on down in this lazarette of sorts. But this hose you see here is for the shower. Just like on a proper cruising boat, get out of the water. You want to shower off with fresh water, you can do so on the first 27. So down below here, you can see this is the built-in autopilot. Really gives you a lot of reliability and a feeling that you can take this boat outside the bay, race this boat shorthanded. You see a really nice job with the installation that Beneteau does at the factory for all of the electronics, all neatly tied up, labeled, secured properly. Looking forward on how well you're going to be able to see this, that is a bladder tank for fresh water. And then all the way forward, that is the refrigeration compressor. Nice to have a little bit more than an ice box, an actual fridge, which is where that solar panel also comes in handy. Look how nice and clean everything is. Nice gel coat work. Really good quality build here. Something else I'm not sure if you can tell, but when you look out on the side deck as it comes aft where you'd be sitting, whether you were steering or just enjoying the ride, you'll see that the decks angle down as they go outboard so that when you're heeled over, you have a little bit more of a secure seating. And then they also have this little bump here to further keep you outboard as you're going upwind or even reaching, sailing along. Nice little Harkin self-tailing winches, obviously a set in the cockpit for the jib and spinnaker, a set of cabin tops for the same purpose. You have a nice little spin lock crossover wheels, give you a little versatility when you're working in the pit. You see things are installed and labeled quite nicely. A bank of clutches over here. We have our Aldhall, Vang, and Cunningham cam cleats, and another bank over here. And then finally your pull out and spinnaker tack on the starboard side. If you were racing this boat, this of course would be on the windward side as you go around the top mark. From an electronic standpoint, this boat is equipped with B&G electronics so far as wind, depth, and speed. And there is a display here on the port side, just above the compass. And then over on the starboard side, the same thing, as well as built-in autopilot control, which also comes with a remote on a lanyard that you would probably keep with you if you were short-handed sailing. A lot of people would opt for perhaps a swing out GPS chart plotter down below, or a handheld iPad would be in fashion these days as well. So a couple of options. You see again all this clear see-through companionway slats and hatch, provides a ton of light down below. And it's pretty neat actually. There's no lock right here mechanism. It's actually a key operation right here. Or a combination lock right there. You can also see as we look at these cockpit benches that they have little snaps, and that is for the included cockpit cushions, and they actually have little seat backs on them, which is quite nice. And then little attachment points for sheet bags here in the cockpit, as well as one on each side of the companionway. So a couple things to look at since we're standing at the transom. Obviously this is a twin rudder boat, so you can see the nicely sized, quite healthy gudgeons here for the rudders. See the diesel exhaust out the back. Also over on the port side, this is a handhold for the ladder that will be installed. So you have a permanent swim ladder, which is quite nice as a way to get back on the boat in all situations. Over there on the starboard side, you have your YAMWARE controls with a nice spin lock removable throttle handle, little race boat feature, also that shore power connection. And then again over here on the port side, you have your shower.